Hi, Professor Isaldeller. Welcome to my YouTube channels. In this video, I teach you velocity triangles, workdone and efficiency of Kaplan turbines, and also discuss the working properties. The velocity triangle we understand with the animation, then after derived equation of workdone, then after efficiency, and fourth is the design procedure for a Kaplan turbines. So first we start with the velocity triangles. So I hope you know the basic of Kaplan turbine. If you don't know, then watch the introductions of Kaplan turbines, its construction, working from the playlist. So this is the blade of the Kaplan turbine. Okay, and this is the outer diameters and this is the inner diameters. Now the water from a guide vanes, it comes with the velocity V1 and it's known as the velocity of the jet at inlet of the runner. Okay. And this line is velocity at the angle alpha 1 with the horizontal directions. Means the guide vane angle is alpha 1. So alpha 1 is the angles between direction of jet and the direction of motion of the blade at inlet, or it is also known as the guide blade angles. This line is denoted as the AB. Then after, this line is in tangential. When the V1 is in tangentials, it is simply divided in the two part, or a two part, that one part is the horizontals and another part is the verticals. The horizontal part of this V1 line is drawn as the horizontal, and this line is the line AC, sorry, line AD, and this line is known as the velocity of wall VW1. V means velocity, W means wall. So VW1 is written as the component of the velocity of the jet V1 in a horizontal direction, not vertical, but it is in horizontal directions. Now another part, that is a vertical part, so we joined this point B and D, so it is the vertical part of the V1 and it is indicated as the VF1. V means velocity, F means flow, and for the inlet we indicate the one down. So VF1 is the component of velocity of the jet V1 in vertical direction. Now next, on this triangle we have indicated another two velocity, that is the velocity of the blade U1 and the relative velocity. So here the new line is added, that is a horizontal line. This, the horizontal line is indicate the U1, that is the velocity of the blade, and this line is denoted as A2C. This U1 means velocity of this blade at the inlet, that is known as the U1. So U1 is written as velocity of the blade at inlet. Now next we need to indicate relative velocity. Relative velocity means with respect to the another, means that is a difference of two velocity. So that is the equation of relative velocity. Generally we know that relative velocity is V1 minus U1. So we know that this is a line of V1 and it is end at the point P. And this is a line of U1, it is ended here at the C. Okay, so what we doing? We connect the end of the V1 velocity and end of the U1 velocity, and that line is indicated as the relative velocity VR1. So this is the VR1, here we return, that is relative velocity of the jet at inlet. That means the relative velocity of the jet with respect to the velocity of the blade, that means it is V1 minus U1. And this angle of relative velocity is indicated as the beta1. And this beta1 is equal to angle between the relative velocity VR1 with the horizontal direction or the direction of the blade. And it is also known as the blade angle at the inlet, means runner blade angle at the inlet. So here we complete the inlet velocity triangles. So here another we draw the outlet velocity triangles. So we all know that Kaplan turbine is an axial flow turbine, means water coming out from the Kaplan turbine, it is in axial directions, means outlet angle alpha 2 of the water is in the 90 degree. Okay, means the water coming in this 90 degree means it is drawn as the vertical line. So here alpha 2 is equal to 90 degree. Okay, now in a inlet what happened, this alpha 1 is less than 90, this line is inclined. It, due to this inclined line, it is divided in two parts, but in this case it's itself have a vertical line, so it is not possible to divide in a horizontal part, means horizontal part of the V2 is VW2. So when the alpha 2 is equal to 90, that means horizontal part is not possible, means horizontal part VW2 is equal to 0. Okay, so this V2 is already denoted as VF2 because horizontal part is 0. So it is vertical part of the V2 is VF2. So here we return the V2 is equal to VF2 and VW2 is equal to 0. Another, we draw the relative velocity line. So at the outlet, the relative velocity is increased, and this line is drawn for the relative velocity VR2, and the angle for relative velocity is beta2. So for inlet, relative velocity angle is beta1. So here we denote it as the beta2, and this line is drawn as the line PQ. Now another is velocity is pending as the velocity U2, that means velocity of the blade at outlet. So similarly, this type of equation is written, the VR2 is equal to V2 minus U2. So here the line is ended for a V2, here the line is ended for a VR2. So what do we simply connect this line, and this line is indicate the velocity of the blade at outlet, and it is denoted as the U2. So we connect the PR and this line is indicate the U2. So here we ending the outlet velocity triangles. Then after we derive the work done and efficiency equation and design procedures for a Kaplan turbine. Before that, I request to subscribe my channels by pressing subscribe buttons and also press the bell icons to get the continuous notification. Now, next we write the equation of the work done. So work done per second for a Kaplan turbine is rho a V1 in bracket VW1 minus U1 plus 1 minus VW2 into U2. So these equations is deriving impact of jet during a series of curve plate. Okay, so this equation is same use. So for understanding of turbine and pump, the most important thing is that you clearly know the impact of jet, then it is easy for you to understand all the derivation of turbines and as well as the pump. So this equation is directly taken from this case. Okay, now this is a common equation, means where is a minus is come. So here I written that negative value, means this negative symbol is come when alpha 2 is greater than 90, means this alpha 2 line is on the right side, means on this side. Okay, so here I draw this line. So this V2 line is on this side. At that time alpha 2 is greater than 90. At that time this equation is come as the negative. Now another case, when the alpha 2 is less than 90, means this V2 line is drawn as here. Okay, so here this angle alpha 2 is less than 90. At that time there is a horizontal part here, that is a VW2. Okay, so this part is VW2. Okay, so at that time this value is coming positive. Okay, but in axial flow turbine, Kaplan turbine as well as in Francis turbine, the VW2 is 0. Okay, VW2 is 0 means this part is 0. So what is the equation of work done? Work done is equal to rho a V1 into VW1 into U1. Okay, so this is the final equations for a work done for a Kaplan turbine. Okay, now this work done equation is also written as that work done per second per unit weight. Means these equations is divided by the weight. Okay, so weight is equal to rho into g. So these rho is cancelled and in lower part g is added, that is a rho a v1 into vw1 into u1 divided by rho into g. Your rho is cancelled. Okay, and we get this equation. Then efficiency is equal to work done divided by input, means output upon input. So what is output for Kaplan turbine? That is a work done, and work done is rho a V1 into VW1 into U1. And what is the input? Input is the hydraulic energy. When the hydraulic energy is come, that is simple equation is rho g q h. Okay, so what we get the final equations? So that is work done divided by rho g q h. Now in equation of work done, the rho is available, so rho and rho is cancelled from the up and down parts. Now this area into velocity, that is denoted as the q. So a into v is equal to q. So q is cancelled for up and down parts. So what is the remaining equation? VW1 into u1 divided by g into h. So this is the final equations for a efficiency of a Kaplan turbine. Another term is the flow ratio kf. So it is the ratio of vf1 upon v1. So velocity of flow at inlet divided by velocity of a jet, that is under root of 2gh. By using these equations, we are able to find out KF for a VF1. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends. Next, we understand the working properties or the design procedures for a Kaplan turbine. So first is area of flow. So working properties and design procedures are also similar to Francis turbine, but there is the only change in area of flow. Okay, means area of the flow is changed, that we understand. So for a Kaplan turbine, area of flow at inlet is equal to area of flow at outlet. So area of flow is equal to pi by 4 into DO square minus DB square, means that is the outer diameter of the runner minus diameter of the hub, that we understand by using this figure, then you can easily understand it. Okay. So before that, I writing these equations, we get the DO square common. O means outer diameter and B is the hub diameters. So we get this common, and DB upon DO is denoted as the N. So D is outside diameter, DB is the diameter of the hub or a boss, and N is ratio of hub diameter to outside diameter, means DB upon DO is written as the N. In this equation, we take the DO common, means outside diameters of the runner. So it is a pi into DO square divided by 4 into 1 minus N square. So here I putting this one figure. By using this, we understand. So this is the outer diameter, means this red color portion. So I using this pencil. Okay, this up to this point is known as the outer diameter, means this is the outer diameter DO. And what is the diameter of hub? This is our hub portion. Okay, so these are the, our diameter of hub. Okay, so this area from the water is flowing from this part and this part. When we seeing from the top, you will seeing the hollow cylinder. Okay, two circles. So we applying the equation is pi by 4 DO square minus DB square. So this way we are able to find out the area of flow. Another equation is similar as Francis turbine, that we already write here. The flow ratio KF is equal to VF1 upon under root of 2GH. Another is the speed ratio KU. KU is equal to U1 divided by under root of 2GH. Discharge for the propeller or Kaplan turbine. So discharge is equal to area of flow into velocity. And area equation we already derived, that is a pi by 4 DO square minus DV square. And the velocity of flow means VF. Okay. So what is the VF? So we write this equation for the equation of KF. So from that, VF1 is equal to KF into under root of 2GH. So this is the equation of a cube. And another is the tangential velocity U1 and U2. So U1 and U2 is equal to pi T N by 60. So by using these equations, we are able to solve the various problem of Kaplan turbine, or we are also able to design the Kaplan turbine. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.